Express enables us to create web servers and APIs with minimal setup. Over the next few tutorials, we'll be using Express to create an API proxy to request data from another API and return it to the consumer. We'll also use Express middleware to help us optimize the API proxy and improve performance. In this tutorial, we'll briefly overview and explain the API proxy we're going to create using Express, as well as the optimizations we're going to be implementing. Our goal in creating an API proxy is to create an API that makes calls to another API on behalf of consumers. To achieve that goal, we will be building an Express server that exposes a custom API that interacts with the NASA Exoplanet API. We previously worked with the NASA Exoplanet API in our tutorials about building an ETL pipeline, and we will be reusing code that we wrote during those tutorials to make API calls to the Exoplanet API. We will also reuse the code we wrote to transform the planet records returned from the Exoplanet API. Our API proxy will return a subset of data that the Exoplanet API provides, allowing us to customize the data to the needs of the consumer. We will also implement some optimizations for the API proxy to improve performance of retrieving the data. These optimizations will take the form of middleware added to the Express server. We'll be implementing caching at the API proxy. Caching allows us to store previously requested data so we can return that data without having to retrieve it from the source each time it is requested. This will help us decrease the latency for consumers and decrease the load on the underlying service. We'll also be implementing compression. Compression reduces the size of a payload, which can speed up transferring the data across the network back to consumers, as well as decrease the bandwidth used by our application. It's useful to implement these optimizations at the API proxy level instead of at the service level for a few reasons. First, in the case of the Exoplanet API, it's a third-party API that we don't directly have control over. Because we don't control it, we have no choice but to add these optimizations on top of it. The API proxy gives us a place to do that. If we did have access to the underlying service itself, implementing these optimizations using an API proxy allows us to leave the service as it is. We don't need to make changes to the service directly, which can be very useful if you are dealing with a legacy service or don't want to make permanent changes to the service. And finally, adding optimizations at the API proxy level allows us to customize those optimizations to the consumer that is intended to communicate with the API proxy. We can focus on optimizations that are most useful to the consuming application and implement them at the consumer's point of contact with the underlying service. To recap, in this short tutorial, we discussed the API proxy we are building. We'll build an API proxy with Express to create a new interface to the NASA Exoplanet API. We also discussed the optimizations we're going to implement. We'll add caching to speed up retrieval of data and reduce load, and compression to return smaller payloads of data over the network, reducing latency and bandwidth usage.